Mining pollution is a global issue, and one of the main problems is water pollution due to metals. Metals can have impacts on ecosystems within rivers, including fish, on livestock that may drink from water, and also even human health. And those are the primary reasons why it's so important that we try and address this type of pollution. We've had a team here at the university that's worked on mining-related pollution issues for more than 20 years now. Nationally, we've influenced government policy and investment in mining pollution-related problems. And internationally, in Europe, we've influenced European Union legislation, and further afield, in South America in particular, we've influenced government policy and practice in how to address problems of mining pollution. In the UK, we've been at the forefront of a development of a novel large-scale treatment system in the heart of the Lake District National Park. The treatment system at Force Crag we refer to as a vertical flow pond, which is a type of treatment we refer to as passive treatment, is that the treatment system doesn't require any energy or any chemicals at all. So once the system's operational, it has a very low carbon footprint, and it's also very low cost to run over the long term. In terms of next steps, I guess there are three particular aspects that I'm interested in. The first is ensuring that we maximise the benefit of the work we've done on passive treatment in the UK by rolling it out internationally. The second is that we'd very much like to look at how we may treat different sources of metal pollution using this technology. And the third thing is that we'd very much like to be in a position where we don't just remove the metals from the polluted waters, but we also recover the metal so that they can be recycled and reused.